Hey guys, what's up? It's Ashish Dayami, and I'm going to be starting a series for Figma components and their variants, and also Autolayout. And what I'm going to be teaching you guys is how to make Autolayout components or their variants so that you can make a responsive design, a design that is easy to use, easy to adjust, and you guys can do whatever you want. Sorry for the notifications, I could discard. Yeah, one more thing, if you guys want to join my Discord, I can drop my link below in the comment, and you guys can do that too. If you need any help with those, I'm always available. And a quick glimpse of what we are going to be studying in these in this series is starting from the basic, how to create a button on Autolayout, how to make a longer version button, a button that is responsive. Whatever you put in that, the frame adjusts according to it, or making a global header just like this one, where you can just put the content inside and resize it, and the things or the objects inside that frame won't fall off the grid, or make the whole page responsive and make the whole chart responsive as well. Or you can also learn how to make components where all the attributes are defined just like this, so you can have whatever kind you want in your system, wherever you want to call it. So we're going to be discussing all the pros and cons for all the component and their variants, and also how to make them on Autolayout. That was just a introduction for what the series is going to be about. So from next tutorial, yep, we're going to start digging. Thanks for watching. Bye.